Welcome back to Hard R. We're on to Change of the Season. Which means just chill for 11 more weeks. Beginning of seed time month, but I have no shovel here. I also have wolves that I've sighted but not confirmed over by where the NERP war camp, whatever it's called, was or is, but it's no longer a war camp, it's just a camp. Still quite injured. But with 8 different injuries all healing at once, that injury will come down significantly over the next couple of days. What do I want to do with my summer? I did mention that I wanted to go to every cultural region. I've been to everyone except, what is it, Cuica tribe up there? I've done hardly anything in Owl tribe. I presumably visited one village. I started up there. That's what that was all about. That was my random start location. And I booked out of there as quickly. Well, very quickly. I was gonna say as quickly as possible, but as X as possible is an overused statement, but we all know what it means. It's rarely the literal truth. I don't think we have any quests outstanding. Nope. So if I want a shovel, I need to get down to Remy, and they probably have a shovel for me down there. But I think I have to go around. Once the ice is all melted, then, you know, I can travel at will with my punt. But this is that time of year where traveling is complicated. Ba-dum-bum. These cuts came from the the nerp I killed. So I think what we're going to do is go find those wolves, make sure that they're they've spawned. Like when you see a picture on the overland map, I don't think that animal technically spawns until you zoom in within like one or two tiles of it. And I think I've done that, but I just want to confirm that. And then we'll kind of head to Remy while we sort of heal up along the way. I think we can start, I'm almost certain we can start building cellars again. So that's another reason we want that shovel. And the sooner the better. And since we're going to be over where the I wanted to see if the mittens, there were two pairs of mittens. If I can wear them. Under my male mittens and over my fur mittens. Wait, no, under everything, right? Under my male mittens, then my male mittens, then my fur. Where are my fur mittens at? I'm not seeing them. Oh, forest ranger fur mittens. So yes, I can. Can I repair? My mittens. No, I can't repair woolen mittens, but let's look at them. So that gives you another incentive. I wonder if the other one I killed had woolen mittens on. That gives you another incentive to kill nerfs. 1, 1, 2, 2, 4. So those would be really helpful in the winter. And they're very light. I think. Anyway, I'm going to wear them. And that's awesome. So I'm looking for my knife and stuff. And my axe, my masterwork spear got downgraded to a fine spear by that very last guy that was crawling around, totally broken. And I threw a javelin at him, hit him. He still comes at me. He hits me in the calf and injures me. And then he blocks my spear and it downgrades to a fine spear. Now it had already taken some damage, but that was the amount of damage that was the damage that put it down into fine. Yeah, so I'll look for the broadheads. I won't take too long at that. But I miss my masterwork spear. Maybe I'll find another one. Bring a short bow. Bring my short bow. I assume it's in that pile. And bring all the arrows. So, I was looking at I rewatched the fight. The mistakes I made. Early in the fight, I was shooting arrow, and my fatigue was growing. And maybe it was the move to shoot an arrow, rest. But man, it's tempting when you've got targets that are there and, you know, what's 1% penalty difference versus maybe this will incapacitate this target. Especially when they started firing back at me, you know. I feel pretty dumb. You rest. Oh, you just got shot in the eye. And maybe if you had fired first. But I don't think I will ever use broadheads against humans again. Because they just weren't effective. Might have been a fluke, but we're going to try using regular, preferably fine arrows, preferably to that superior arrows, but not broadheads. We can look at the lamellar hauberk. Weighs 20 pounds. It's been a while since we looked at lamellar. Decent coverage. 3, 3, 3, 5 against edge. Now that kind of shows you why the broadhead arrows might have been not very effective, because whereas point was only 3, point would be a regular arrow, edge would be a broadhead arrow. Let's compare that to, say, the elk fur overcoat that weighs roughly a third less. 4, 2, well, squeezing I don't really care about, but 4, 2, 2, 2, 4. This go down from, no, I didn't say that right. 4, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. 4, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. 3, think the Elk Fur Overcoat is just better. And if, look at all the coverage. It goes down to your wrists and your, it covers your knees. Now against Edge specifically, not as good. Against pretty much everything else. See, this doesn't cover your knees and it doesn't do much for your arms, only your shoulders. And it weighs 50% more than the overcoat. I'm glad that I didn't use any of the stuff I found in that treasure cache. I will have access to those things for unlimited use once Please the Forest is completed. So I was also thinking of getting some tree bark this time of year, but I won't be using that Masterwork small knife to do it. Not this time of year, because change of season is the current one. So sorry for this summary if this was boring or whatever, but I just wanted to share my thoughts on a few things, let you know where we're going. So, have I got everything I kind of want? Got my staff, my axe, my bow, my arrows, my knife, my currently best spear, my battle gear. Roscoe's fur, Roscoe's bone. Hunt, paddle, traps, food. I look pretty much set to go. I'm only doing 2 miles an hour, but it is what it is. So, drop the punt, wield the paddle. Oh, I don't think I filled my skin. I need to do that. That's good. Apply skin. And we're bringing our punt with us, so don't expect to find a punt here when we return. Zooming in for a squirrel. There's an elk. It's due west of that hill there, that's just due southwest of that mountain. Not hunting it now, but I think I should trigger it. Okay, it's moved. It's a bull elk of some kind. Just a regular bull elk. Oops. It's just going to chill until I hit it with my spear. Okay. There's some deer. A 4 east and 2 north of me. I think they moved, but. I'm thinking of, you know, should I try to hunt injured? If they were like, let me see what terrain we're dealing with here. What is that guy doing? Go away. If they were in a mire, I'd consider it because I could shoot arrows at them, but it's too much work and I'll be healed to where it's much easier to hunt them in a few days. I probably won't be here in a few days, but it's a separate issue. Not zooming in for a squirrel. Just 2 west and 1 north, right? And then there's that other elk, kind of too far away. Okay. Fox, we'll eat a bit of fox. So, quite a ways to go. Not zooming in for a bird. I guess I should have stopped for a blessing from the sage, but not turning around to get it. Game everywhere. I think that's three up and six west. Oh my gosh. I think that's due west, yeah, of the shelter. Like five west of here, and the other one is the second notch down where the land goes into the lake, due north of this one. Maybe it's only four west of here, four or five. Usually when I'm wrong, I underestimate how far, but I think it was five, wasn't it? Small elk. So this one we could probably hunt. If we wanted to. I could see that being a useful thing to do for people who are like, well, I'm really injured or I'm slow, how can I hunt, blah, blah, blah. I could see how it goes and say, okay, well, first you need to find game in a mire. Then you need to put an arrow in it, and then you need to yeah, I've bookmarked it. Why don't we tentatively plan to do that? Although, yeah, it's not like it's in the center of a giant mire. It's right next to forest. So this might not work out, but don't come at me, bro. Okay. This is where we left a bunch of NERP gear. The birch bark shoes too, I think. Let's look at them. Let's see if we can wear them first. No. Can't wear them over or under your fur footwear, I guess. Or your foot rags. Something's blocking them anyway. So, let's eat while the cuts aren't stale yet. But let's look at those birch bark shoes. Huh. Provide one against blunt, one against point, and one against squeeze, and one against edge, and one against tear. I don't think I've ever seen a 1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1-1 before. So they're not completely useless. Problem is they can't be layered properly and they're less useful than the other things. Now if I had a pair that weren't quite so damaged, maybe they would do better than 1-1-1-1-1 in certain areas at least. Or maybe they wouldn't, because you know it's birch bark. So, it's hot, we're tired. Let's get this junk out of my shelter for now. Okay, let's check on the cuts if they're stale. Not yet. Ooh. 8 injury just went away. Up to 4 miles an hour. That would make the hunt easier. The rain makes it at a minimum annoying. I also wanted to go look for those arrows and I'm doing that in the rain. Anyway, let's see what we're doing here. Take off our, this is the junk gear. Okay, let's take off our battle gear. Drop everything. Okay, so we can wear the mittens and still be underweight, so that's beautiful. Let's look at our warmth. So our hands are dark green for the first time for warmth. Staff. And We've got to do, try to stay at 4 miles an hour if we can. Speaking of which, let's do physician before we go so we don't forget and neglect to do it at all, like I sometimes have a tendency to do. Yeah, those herbs seem to really help. This also gives us a chance to maybe get the rain to stop. It is seed time month, so it's going to rain a lot this month. Like, I guess that's April, right? So I didn't level physician, unfortunately. I was just thinking as the starting five, I can never decide on a fifth. Maybe physician is a good one. Because it's very hard to level. Well, unless you cheese, unless you're greasy, it's very hard to level. And it just seems, it's a skill you'd want to have, for sure, at above a novice level. And what did I level instead? Probably like shield. Am I ever using shield in combat with NERFs? No, because I wouldn't want to use something I'm only competent with. When I'm using something I'm a grandmaster with and something I'm an expert with instead. So, all of our physician is done, and we will spend a bit of time looking to see if we can hunt this elk. Oops. There's the elk, so we'll give it some number of weather lures, probably five. If it doesn't use them to its benefit, that isn't my problem. It went into the forest, trying to get it out of the forest by flanking it, but I am slow and it is fast. In the northwest, that's what I want to hear. Except it was in the west. Sneaky elk. Could have sworn it was running down here. Did it totally fake me out? So let's see. I've heard you just don't do archery in the rain, so. And that makes sense to me. Now it's back in the forest. Running away in the west. It's not exactly hauling butt. I doubt it's fatigued though. Well, it's probably slightly fatigued. Whatever that means, 5% or whatever. There's some herb lore I could do, but. Should be tracks around. Running in the southwest. Seem to have lost the trail. Did it go north? No, that's where it came from. Northwest. Again, it's. Anyway, there it is. That is not moving very quickly. It's still running. Well, it was still running. Yeah, I thought it wasn't moving quickly, but I think it was just styling a bit. Which way did it go? Went the way I didn't check is the way it went. Oh, and I run into a tree. That was brutal. I felt like I was making good progress until there. And now I've basically probably reset its... still running. So that's a good way to kind of give you an indication of, well, you can look, you can just look at the animal, but if you can't see the animal, yeah, it's not running anymore. Am I going in circles? It feels like I am. This is definitely where I've been before, right? And it just sort of disappears here. Oh, this I don't think, well, no, I don't think I... Did I? Feels very much like I'm going in circles. These are only fresh. Those are only fresh. Yeah, so... Because it feels, when you're playing the game, like you're just as fast at 4 miles an hour as you are at 10. Because one click, one move, and there's no... You can move as fast as you click, but you just don't keep up as well. It's just hard to track them on this light neon green stuff. And if you can't see tracks, then it's a real challenge. Unless you get super lucky in guessing which way it went. Okay, this is newish. These are old. I was hoping it came out, but it looks like it didn't. Or it came out and no. I'm so confused. That's quite fresh. Unless it walked backwards, this doesn't make sense. Back. No. Yeah. No. None of this. Yeah. No. Felt like I was doing better in the rain. Okay, this was kind of a bit of luck to catch up with him here. I think we're maybe close behind. Maybe he went out into the, where we can see him for a shot. whole lot of styling. And then back in the forest. Great. Wait, that even says west. I'm just hoping. And we got, oh, that's hour old. And it's raining again. Well, that didn't work very well. Why don't we try stealth? Grouse knocked me out of stealth. There it is. Is that a clear shot? Maybe I should have taken it. Seemed a bit. He hasn't seen me yet. Maybe I should wait and hope. Stealth in the rain got us there. I mean, it was probably just dumb luck, but southwest. Okay, there it is. Okay, that's a clear shot. Now, is it greasy to shoot an arrow in the rain? It's a bit greasy, I don't know. Come on, rain, just stop. Raining a little. If it's raining a little, could you just stop raining, please? Don't go back in the forest. No. How is this raining? Well, to be fair, the time doesn't trying to get around it. So we'll go back out in the mire. Northwest. But I think I showed that you can get within range to take a shot with an arrow. And if you can do that repeatedly, then eventually, at least hypothetically, you should be able to injure it to the point where you can kill it or run it down and kill it. No javelins on me. And it's back in the forest. Well, let's just try tracking it again. hopefully it doesn't go over old tracks like it was doing before as much, or leave any tracks at all that we can see. That's nice of it. Way in the east. Running away in the east? Or is that the old one? I think that's the old one. I only see two there. still running. Not running now. Not running. Crap. I was hoping. That it had been styling enough. In the south. Southwest. What are you doing? I've been pretty good about that, this hunt. No, that's not it. That's not it. That's not it. Maybe it's because I'm stealthing that time is passing and I've totally lost the track. Well, there's no maybe about it. I've totally lost the track. Stealth, have I gained any? Can't believe I haven't gained any. I've done a lot of stealthing this hunt. Like I've been here before, because I have. Where does it go from here? Not there. Not there. Not there. Just disappears into thin air. Which is no fun when you're injured and the rain keeps coming back. Look fresh. Well, they're only fresh though. Quite fresh. Quite fresh. Fresh. All right, we'll try this. Quite fresh. Quite fresh. Quite fresh. I'll update you if that changes. That's enough sneaking. Okay, well, that was exciting. Still don't know what the puzzling grass is. I'll figure it out eventually. Okay. Didn't go back in, at least not then. Since when do birds not fear me when I've got a bow and arrow wielded? Out for so long and I didn't know. This is right up there with the most frustrating hunts of all time, not gonna lie. This is the lazy man's hunt. Just keep coming back here and hope that it wandered back. Because I don't know where it went. Looks so dark. I'm like, oh, got it? No, old. Now we can't distinguish from 1 hour old or another hour old. But that's mainly due to laziness and just running around and hoping instead of relentlessly following the freshest track, which is what we should have been doing. We can't do that now because everything says an hour old, and I don't want to follow the wrong hour old, so we just have to walk around until we find something that's fresher than that. Or if we follow it somewhere where we haven't explored already, then that very likely is the fresher of the hour old stuff. Like if we find a track here, this is just more puzzling grass, isn't it? Yeah, let's not do that then. Northeast. Very fresh. Our old. Very fresh. Okay, slow down. Stop messing around. These are old. These look fresh. Those are old. Fresh. Fresh. Where do you go? Thud from the northwest, probably bird on bird action. What are you doing to me, elk? But you're trying to kill me. Well, yeah, but... Is it worse to kill someone than to drive them absolutely crazy? Okay, yes it is, by the way. Well, is it? Anyway, let's say that it is. Certainly more illegal. Not running is the annoying part. Feels like I just came through here. I don't... Supposed to be a Grandmaster Tracker. What's the dealio? Maybe... The injury affects my tracking skill too. They're running. Still running? No. I don't need it to be breathless. I just need it to be fatigued enough it can't totally style on me. And it would be nice if it would stay out of this stuff I can't track it properly on. Here it goes styling on me again. I mean, on the one hand, it gives me a chance to catch up. But that's only if I guess right. Oh, I guessed right. Which freaking way? Way up there or way down here? Oh, it went both. Because it goes 100 miles an hour. Hour old. How long have I been doing hour old? Some hours old. Probably since I said, oh, I guessed right. Because I never guessed. Oh, stop whining. Okay, very fresh. Very fresh, very fresh, very fresh. Nothing there. And this is old, right? This is old. So where the heck did it go? Old, old. Very fresh. Hours old, very fresh, very fresh, very fresh. How can that be very fresh? Old. Very fresh. And it starts raining again. I don't think the rain is, well, the rain has kept us from taking a shot with our bow and arrow. When we had the opportunity, but boy, I need a break. Thank you for sitting through this, and I'll see you next time.